EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the London Black Knights. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Carry for Cam Akers, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run? Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, in a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got to like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
They go play action. Mayfield. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. But he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A good pickup, 17 yards, and also a Rams first down. Mayfield on play action. That's complete to his tight end, Higbee. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Well, this crowd does not like that call.
Understandable reaction from them. That's their team that the penalty's going against. But you and I both know they're going to take care of the quarterback.
So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's first and goal. They'll run here with Akers. Say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal at the 10-yard line.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Mayfield firing quickly. It's complete. And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. Now Mayfield. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the seven they wanted, but they'll take the three.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they had three first downs and 3 points. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Joe Mixon, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Second down, here's Mason. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30. The Rams calling on their nickel set here defensively for third down. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. When you give up points on the opening drive, in this case a field goal, you'd hate to go 3 and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking a fine line mentally, too, as a coach, isn't it? Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave up a field goal. Let's go back and at least equal that, guys. But if we don't, you don't want them to feel like it's the end of the world, either. Nice that they were able to pick up the first down there, help them relax a little bit.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45. With that run, double check my math, yes, he has hit 8,000 career rushing yards.
And that's fantastic. That means he's now approaching the top 50 all-time rushers in NFL history. That means he just sped past Terrell Davis, who's in the Hall of Fame. And now he's just got to go ahead and be strong and run hard because he's chasing down Larry Zonka.
On 2nd down, Mixon. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That 2nd down play nets a -4.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 1st quarter. So 3rd down, and defensively the Rams have added 2 extra DBs. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow being chased out left. And that is incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
So they bring out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
from the 25 on second down. Mayfield. That's into the hands of Akers, complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
3-0 after one on EA Sports. About six up to midfield.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
The last run got six. Now second and four. Mayfield now from the 50. And this is incomplete. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. Face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's got his man on the crossing route. But he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That third down conversion, good for 23. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Mackenzie Alexander in on the tackle. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Second and nine. Mayfield flush to his right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they've retained their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Graham Gano on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0.
Makes the score Rams 10, Black Knights nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. To return it, Darius Phillips. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
They'll take over. First down and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
That catch good for only a couple.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. He'll buy some time right. That one complete to Dede Westbrook. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 2 yards there, a first down.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Mixon with a first down carry. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second down now, Mixon. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. It's Burrow sliding out of the pocket. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. First target, first catch, and a first down. Give to Mixon. A gain of 3, second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front, so if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him, picks up 3 on that carry.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half, 10-0 our score. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And they move this all the way down to the 9. That's good for 28 yards.
Nice job there utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Give it to Mixon. And they get him down at the 1. He had the broken tackle, but ultimately could not get into the end zone. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive. Second and goal from the 1. Return to the power game to try to get in. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. Call it a gain of 1 yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's 3rd and goal.
3rd and goal.
Now Burrow, flushed out right, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. Third and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack, and now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
On now is the kicker Jason Myers for the field goal try. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And that hits off the left upright, and it caroms away, no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So we would have figured that one to be 3 points in the bank, but this game, you know, can be unpredictable at times.
Yeah, he knew he needed to pull it ever so slightly to get it going in the right direction, but he seemed to put a little too much on it, and from short range, that is a bad miss for an NFL kicker.
So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, as they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting.
Now Burrow loses the football. And now the Rams have got it, going the other way. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. And they came out of the locker trailing. Not a good way to start this second half with their first drive.
Can't imagine that the discussion at halftime encompassed this at all. In fact, I'm sure they talked about, okay, kind of wipe the slate clean, start the second half, and let's go out and play the way we know that we can. That's not a great example of it.
They didn't envision that. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Mayfield. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
And 9 yards to go.
So they've been unable to capitalize on a great field position as of yet. Here's third and nine. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Trying to get it to Anderson, but it's intercepted. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick, and he returns it here to his own 18-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Burrow will throw, eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
He was brought down at the 26. That's a gain of 7. Makes it third and 2.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Burrow on play action. On the move to his left. He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
Yeah, we dominate today.
The struggles continue here offensively. Still nothing for him on the scoreboard, and now an interception.
Yeah, the offense looks extremely sluggish, not really in sync at all. Dare I say, it looks like it got left behind in customs.
Oh, you've had that in your back pocket. You were waiting for that.
Probably should have left it in my back pocket, too.
Well played. Following the interception, Mayfield. He'll throw complete to Cam Akers. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Field on first down. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Flush to his right. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
4 yards to go.
Face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. On third down, here's a run by Akers. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play, and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Field to throw it. This will be caught at about the six. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. From 3 yards out, and the Rams tack on to their advantage. Gano for the extra point.
I think it's easy to say mission accomplished on that drive. The goal was to increase the lead. They did exactly that.
Makes the score Rams 17. Black Knights nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily when you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
On third down, Burrow into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And the return will stop right around the 25.
All right, work with me, partner. This is a classic understatement. Their execution has been very poor. Last three drives, two interceptions and a fumble. Winning football? We're not seeing it right now.
They'll run on first down. Akers, they get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Going right back to Akers. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Play action now. Here's Mayfield rolling to his right. He may try and run for this, but he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up 1st and 10. Now a run with Akers. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Mayfield off the play fake. Buying time to his left. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the return will stop him well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line.
We'll take that. We'll take that.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it?
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Second and 11. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. And that is incomplete. A a lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
The offense on third down, they've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 11. Now it's Burrow. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Take it in at the 22. A nice job getting free on the return for 13 yards. And the Rams will go on offense here for the first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line as they try to finish things off in this fourth quarter, and that current 5-game win streak looking like it's going to go to 6. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Now a throw here to his running back and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Brings up 2nd and 9 at the 42-yard line.
Here's 2nd and 9. To throw, Mayfield. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
The Rams on 3rd down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 4. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a 1st down. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on 3rd down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, 3rd down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Mayfield now looking to throw on 1st down. And almost intercepted. It would have been his 2nd pick of the game. Instead, it'll be 2nd down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
2nd and 10 from the 33-yard line. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds.
And that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the 5-yard line.
First down, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. C.J. Ham, his first touchdown on the year. And the Rams add on to their lead. And they're able to up the lead by one more.
Makes the score Rams 24, Black Knights nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. On the return, Phillips. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
At the 21-yard line.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Burrow looking to pass. Flushed out right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. And for the defense, their third sack of the game.
That number tells you that they're starting to put it together with their defensive game plan. They're starting to feel pretty good about what the offense is doing, bringing the pressure at the right time, and putting the quarterback on the ground.
From the gun on third down is Burrow. Got an open man, that's Campbell. Yeah, he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
On first down, Mixon. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
He was brought down at his 49-yard line. A gain of 5 brings up second and 5.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Burrow going to get this into the hands of Mixon, his running back. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 40. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Throwing now, Burrow on first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Trying to get it there to D.D. Westbrook, and that'll bring up second down.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
Again, it's Burrow on 2nd and 10. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. To the air again, Burrow. Catch made here by Campbell. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 25-yard line. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. And 10, Joe Burrow. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. It's a gain of 7, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
What a game this defense continues to play, huh?
Yeah, they've been aggressive from the first snap, and they've controlled this ball game. But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you've got to match that aggressiveness. No points so far in this game. Moving the football, got to be that way to go against them and try and get some points on the board.
And I'm curious on the defensive side, if they stay aggressive, because you know they want to pitch this shutout.
Yeah, they have to be aggressive, but they also have to be smart about it as well, because one mistake could turn into 6 points.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left.
It's now 3rd and goal.
This likely a must-have, 3rd and goal. A final shot now for Burrow. And this is going to be caught. So it affects the final score, not the outcome, but it is a late touchdown here on the game's final play. Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot
there. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Well, at least at the very end, there's something to take away. They lost the game, but got in the end zone, got a 2-point conversion as well. I don't know, though. In the end, you still lost the football game.
You still lost the game, but maybe they were just capitalizing on the flurry at the end, right? You score the touchdown, keep the momentum going, go for 2. Maybe they're working on something for down the road. As you said, it doesn't matter. You lose the game, but you finish with a touchdown and a successful 2-point conversion.
Some sort of a...
flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a flag on the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Flag on the play.
Holla.
That's a flag on the play.